Hey, this is Kevin Kitchens with Once Upon a Game, and I'm here to do another unboxing video. This time it's for Sargent's D-Day. This is the board game version of the Sargent's miniatures game. It's designed by Jeff Billings, put out by Lost Battalion. I jumped on this one. This has been out actually for 2 or 3 years now. However, unlike the miniatures game, well, we'll see it when we open it up in a minute. The miniatures game is really good. Same system, pretty much. Some variations based on the fact that this one uses standees and doesn't use measured movement, unlike the miniatures version, which uses a combination of miniatures, I mean, of ruler measurement and square counting. Excuse me. So this one does have some rules variations. For the most part, it's the same basic system, which is a really, really cool system. And we're going to take a look at what you get inside the box. This is a $70 price point. The miniatures game starts off at about $90, I believe. And you get a lot more content trading off the miniatures. The miniatures are awesome. They're hand-painted. They're 20-millimeter scale. Beautifully done. I mean, beautifully done. One thing you'll see in this one is that this takes up about a fourth less space, whereas the each square in the miniatures game is a 5-inch square. These are 2.5 inches square. So it takes four of these to make up one of those, which is helpful for me. You know, with limited space, you can set up bigger battles. You need a lot more table space, obviously, for the miniatures game. So anyway, let's crack the seal, see what you get inside. I got my copy here from Noble Knight. They had a sale going recently, so I jumped on it. I picked up an expansion pack too. Plays up to four. It's not specifically designed for solo. I did not have much trouble soloing it as a two-player, you know, play against myself kind of thing. It could be. Love this. Crinkly sound. You know, it'd be nice to get an AI for this, though. There's some people have come up with ways to do that. But for the most part, you lose a little bit of the hidden nature of it. But in reality, it plays just like any other war game. Your strategy is the thing. Each side is going to have different objectives, so you can work toward those. And it's just fun to play. So let's see what you get inside the box. apparently we have a checklist, which is pretty awesome. Tells you everything you're supposed to get, including rubber bands and bags. So that's pretty nice. Lost Battalion is a small company. They actually paint the miniatures in-house, I believe, and do all the printing and everything directly. So the artwork is really nice. It's a comic style, not like Heroes of Normandy, where that was kind of a cartoonish style. These are told through in kind of a comic book storyboard format. So get a rule book. I've read the PDF online already because I was comparing it to, it's about 40 pages. Large print, pretty well explained. There's a few questions that'll come up, edge cases, things like that. But for the most part, it's pretty well covered. And as always, the BGG forum is a great place to go for information. Here's the mission book, chapter one, the invasion of Normandy. You get a lot more missions in the board game version. Again, you get a lot more content. You get 20 in the miniatures game. You get 10 soldiers. In the board game, you get 22 soldiers. You split evenly Germans and Americans. So nice quality, nice artwork, matte finish. So you'll see the puzzle piece board come out in a little bit, but this is how you set up your mission. Each tile is double-sided, so you got the A side and the B side, and you'll put them together in this fashion. Click them together, and you got your entry locations. here we have scenario 13. Okay, now this apparently came out of the book. I mean, you saw me take it out, but I thought I was just pulling something out. So obviously the staple didn't hold, but that can be remedied. If your storyboard, I guess you could call it. You'll have a deck of story cards that go here. Three come out that determine the actions that can be taken during each round. It's a really great system. And then you've got event options at the bottom, cause and effect. And if they match up, so if the right side of this card matches the left side of this card in terms of type, then that event happens. And rarely, you don't get them every turn. Rarely you might get two. It says you might get seven in a whole game, but it's an excellent way of doing the event system rather than just doing a die roll. All right, so we have a ordnance card. Apparently different things you can buy. You can trade victory points for gear. So how it basically works is kind of like X-Wing, where you set up based on points, or any miniatures game really, where you set up based on points. It's like, okay, this is a 20-point game. And so you'll put together soldiers that total 20 points, but you can also maybe pad it, spend some of your points to buy these, you know, additional equipment. There may be options to trade in your points for initiative or other things. So we've got one stack of tiles here that is still in the shrink. And this was assembled by Mike. I love the personal touch here on this. All right. They ain't got some here that are apparently not in shrink. Interesting. Oh, it looks like the shrink burst in transit. There it is right there. So it's loosely packed, but they came out. So a lot of tiles. In the miniatures game, it's going to be different. You get 18 tiles. You get 16 small and two what are called landmark tiles, which are double-sided. So those are 5 inches each and 10 inches each. In this case, these are 2.5 inches square and double-sided. They are laser cut. Now, these are already punched. Now, one thing to note is that they're jigsaw pieces. One thing to note is that a lot of people, like with victory point games, have an issue with soot on the laser cutting. And I've never had a problem with victory point. But I will say that these definitely do have a soot to them. It comes off in the hand. So you're definitely going to want to wipe them down the first time you use them. But they're beautiful. They're slick, glossy. And that was actually one of the issues I had with the miniatures game, is that putting the ruler down, these are very slick, and they would slide. You know, the ruler would slide. You're not knocking your guys around, you know. But I'm blaming myself, so I trust myself to put it back. So here you get a nice stack of tiles here. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 8, 10, 12, 14, 16, 18, 24. So there's 24. There's another 24. It's 48. Like I said, you only get 18 in the other game. All right. So now we've got our soldiers. Counters, markers. Again, Mike. This is Julia. Thanks, Julia. Thanks, Mike. You got your placemats for putting your cards down that correspond to the phases. You have your some more soldiers and their cards. Explain all those, and then we'll open one in a minute. Lots of good stuff in here. Looks like there's two soldiers. Now, they also have what's called, here's story cards. Lois got these. Thank you, Lois. You have soldiers. You have story decks. You have a turn track. Yeah, goes up to 32 turns. That's awesome. Some missions may be turn limited. Usually the missions, at least the ones I played in the miniatures game, are card driven. So you turn out three cards out of the story deck and every turn, and when you can't place three cards for whatever reason, the turn's over. So that's what you got there. get your story decks here. This is cards 1 through 64, 65 through 128. Okay, so we'll open those up. Hopefully not get soot all over them. They are not shrink wrap. They come in the nice little tuck boxes. So this is what I was saying about the events that can unfold. So this one says landmark, the right side. And so if this was happened to be next to here, you would get a landmark event. And it would say the soldiers in graveyard L4A are afraid and treat all zip damage results as pins. So anytime they're attacked and get a zip, they actually get pinned. So it's a clever mechanic for getting events into the game without being too many. And you'll pull some of these cards. Each scenario will tell you which of these cards to actually use. So if a map is not using L4A, this one won't even be in there as an option. One cool thing is that there are also what are called characters. So any copy of, for instance, this board game, base game that you get are going to have the same character figures. And those may be referenced in the story. So they may be vital to the story. This character takes a hit. This character shoots. This character does something. And then you're going to have random soldiers as well. Another neat feature is that some soldiers have ranks, sergeants. They will have different cards giving them different abilities based on the rank that you pick. And obviously the higher ranks are going to cost more. But they also give you better features like the ability to draw more cards and do different things. So we got the different, we got the story deck. We've got more soldiers. And the cool thing here is that they've given you not only a tray to keep your decks organized, because like I said, each like some soldiers that have ranks are going to have more decks or more cards. So you want to keep them all sorted. So they've given you a tray. Also have a card here that tells you how to assemble the bases, which we'll get in a minute. They give you a vacuum tray to hold the cards, but they also went ahead and give this nice laser cut tray topper to just make it fit the theme a little bit better. So like your story decks, we'll go back in here. Counters can go there. You can put your, you know, access forces there and allied forces there. And then your tiles. Now, one thing I am... Oh, wait a minute. They're probably in here. As I said, they were what are called landmark tiles. And they are inside this package. We'll go ahead and open and do all of Mike's handiwork. And open that. All right. So what you get here. Now, you get... Again, nice laser cut, but you're going to want to clean them. So you got turn markers. These are your corner pieces. You can see those there. And these are some of the edge pieces to make the frame that the map's going to go in. Again, one thing I like about this is it takes up a lot smaller playing surface. And you don't have to use a ruler to measure. You measure by squares. Which, if you're a miniatures person, you may like. For me, it was just easier to do the squares. So these are counters, victory point trackers, which are nice because this is something that the version of the miniatures game I had did not come with. We have grenades, and we have grenades for both sides. They have the pin markers as well. Move, and you get move plus, and you get move plus plus, which is not a programming language. These compensate for basically a soldier can usually move in this game one square, and if they need to move like on a diagonal, that counts as two squares. But if they can only move one square a turn, what they can do is they can save their move, take a move plus counter, and that means they've got an extra. They've built up a move, so they can move, two or three the next time, or two times, three times what their base move is, in case there's vehicles that you can add later that will probably be able to move more. So, but in the end, you can still only move the number of squares that you can move. You're just paying the price for leaving more difficult terrain. So another neat feature is you pay the terrain cost leaving not entering, which is kind of neat. So it's the more difficulty of getting out of there. So you got a sheet of counters there. You got more border pieces, which we'll set up. And they're very loose, so I'm going to slide those off to the side. More border pieces, longer ones. The reason you got longer and shorter ones is because when you get down to these are your entry areas. And you will mark them accordingly based on the map. So when you set up your frame, you'll set your entry areas, and then when you pick an entry area, that's where you come in at. So that's those. But one thing I did not find is the what are called landmark tiles. Do they go below the board? They are not below the board. I do not see them. Let me see. Did I miss them somewhere? So I'll show you in the map setup here. You've got the small tiles and you got landmark tiles. And this copy did not include landmark tiles, which number one stinks because I cannot show that to you, but number two stinks because I cannot play the game until I get those. So I will have to reach out to Lost Battalion and see about getting those. I do not have them anywhere. Very interesting. Okay, quick correction here. Turns out that the landmark tiles are included. As you can see, we needed the four unique tiles. They still make the 5x5, but instead of having to recut them, as far as internally with a 5x5 grid to match the I need a 5x5 square to match the edging that they just did them as a quick assembly of the other tunnels. And you can tell that they're different. And these have the two teeth, two tunnels and two grooves. And these have a symbol in the big section. And the legend, the logo, always faces up, so you can always piece them together pretty quick. So my bad. When you look at the picture online, it shows these assembled. And so they look like, because it's so far away, it looks like they're a 5x5 tile, but they're actually included in the stack of tiles. So two landmarks in this one, and two landmarks in that one as well. So that's my addendum. Sorry about that. Sorry for the confusion. Thanks. So you'll see here's some of the soldier characters I was talking about. Carter, Harrison, and Fields, Thielen, Meyer, and Dreyer. Those are the characters that could be named. The rest of them are all random named, random characters. So you get a rifle leader and assault section. You get a type, but the names may be different. So if you get another set, you'll get these guys. Will be all just different random. We'll open up a soldier deck real quick. And what I'll do is I'll try to pick one that I know is a officer. So I can show you the different cards real quick. So how it works is you'll pick your squad. And Here's Thielen. Thielen is an officer for sure. Lois assembled this. You'll assemble your squad, and then based on their rank, each soldier is going to have four base cards that are always with them, based on their nationality, and then three based on their rank. Most of the guys are going to be private, so they have the same three. The officer is based on which rank you pick, right? So hit like, for instance, here is Thielen's cards. Let's find Thielen. Okay. Let's get all his cards out here. Okay. So you'll see we have Thielen here. And the zoom, I have to do the focus here. Okay. There we go. So Thielen is an Unteroffizier, a Feldwebel, and a Gefreiter. And all you my German-speaking friends, I'm sorry, but I've probably screwed that up. So he starts out with 7 victory points as a private. You can take him as a Feldwebel as 10, or you can take him as a Unteroffizier for 12 victory points. Okay? So his abilities are going to differ based on the things that he can do. For instance, during a look command, he can draw three cards, he can draw two cards, he can rally, he can hold cards, which means he can hide them and save them for another turn. So these are the officer cards. These are the ones you're going to pick. This is actually the unit card that's going to sit and give you your reference for the game. And then you'll see he has a rank insignia here. Trying to find it. Actually, no, it's right here. Sorry, that's his nationality. His rank insignia here. And those are going to match some of these cards. So you'll see here he's got... this is a three. This is a three. This is a two. Okay, this is his as a private. They're blank. So here's a three. There's a two. So he's going to have three of each. Blank, blank. Okay, so then he's got his four base cards, which all have his nationality on them. So those are always going to go in his pile. And then based on the rank you pick, he's going to have three more cards that go with it. And you'd put those in. So for all your troops, let's say you have five soldiers on the field for that battle. For those five, you're going to have seven cards each. Four nationality cards, three rank cards. You're going to shuffle all those together into your draw pile for the game. And those are going to drive the game. So when you, and I'm probably going in more detail than I should for an unboxing, but I'm just going to explain this real quick. So if you're interested, you can grab a copy. So when you start out, you're going to draw three cards plus any that your officers give you. We saw he had a draw one card on there. So when you start out the turn, let's say you draw four cards, okay? And then the story deck is going to say, you know, when you lay out the three cards for the story deck, it'll say move, then shoot, for example. So you have to play for your team on that phase. There's three phases in the round. For that phase, you have to play a move or a shoot card. So I could say, okay, I want to play this move card, I want to play this shoot card, or whatever. But you have to play a card for each phase if you can. If you can't, then you have to draw. You have to discard everything and draw until you get something. And you have to prove that you couldn't do it. So you definitely, you know, it's an honor system. So then what happens is, so we say we had a move in the first phase, and when it's your turn to play, then what happens is you've got these different points on the card that say... who can do what? Try to focus that a little better there. See, got to focus in there. Okay. So here, Phelan owns this card. So Phelan can do a move order. And then you've got the potential for these other bubbles. Let's see if that one's got other bubbles on it. I do not. So you also have a section here and a section here. Now here, any three soldiers may move. So he can do a move, then any of your three soldiers can move. And then if you have another option, a narrator box, they call it, here, Thielen may rally. So you can choose any, or you can do this section first, this section first, this section first, and you have to do them complete. And in fact, he has a move, shoot, or look, which means you can play it on any of those three. It's a very versatile card. But so Thielen can do one of these, then three soldiers can move, three soldiers can shoot, two soldiers can sight, and Thielen may rally. So it's a very versatile system. And then these cards are also drawn from your deck to resolve combat. And so you calculate the range, and then you would draw a card and say, oh, okay, he's at short range. So at short range, he hits and he misses because you get everything above it, right? So if you're at close range, you would get two hits, hit, hit, miss. So it's actually a really good system. Sorry, I'm gushing about it. So anyway, that is what you get in the box. We get... let me show you the soldiers real quick. They come also on a laser cut thing. They already have adhesive set up. So you're going to stack these together to create your unit. And then one cool thing about the board game version is that this counter here, pop it out. This counter here is actually what is going to be on the board moving around. So it's kind of hidden movement until he's sighted. And then you flip it over and you put the standee in its place on the board. In the miniatures game, the miniatures are always on the board, and you have to sight them and put a sighted marker with them. So this actually works out a lot better. So the net result is you end up with this stacked unit. It's got the little zig cut. It makes a little nice heavy unit to move around on the board. and I think you get 22 of these in the game. I was really disappointed about those missing boards. I'm sure they'll replace them. Let's see, components. Just leave you real quick with how many you get here. Oh, it doesn't tell you. It doesn't tell you how many you get. Well, it's 20-something. It's either 22 or 24. Maybe it's 26. Maybe 13 each. Right, we can see we've got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18. And this is 18. That can't be right. Anyway, unfortunately, it doesn't actually list the components. I know I'm rambling. Sorry. Hope you enjoyed seeing what's in the box. But I will do a review sooner. It is an awesome, awesome game. Definitely be great with two players. But if not, it's definitely good with it's good solo. So thanks for watching. And you'll have a great day. Bye-bye.